Hi, this is Dr. Mark Trolice, Director of Fertility Care, the IVF Center in Orlando, Florida. And today we're going to talk about the difference between IUI, or intrauterine insemination, and IVF, or in vitro fertilization. The most common questions that were asked is, what is the difference between these two procedures? Well, basically, when a couple presents for fertility treatment, they are undergoing an evaluation that consists of a hysterosalpingogram to check a woman's uterus and fallopian tubes for patency, to determine whether she is ovulating, and also the man's sperm count. And based on that, we can direct the couple into the most effective treatment option. The decision is based on a physical, emotional, and financial investment of the couple, as well as the age of the female. So what is IUI? Intrauterine insemination, or artificial insemination, is a minor office procedure where sperm are placed inside the uterine cavity. Now, the man produces sperm, and it is washed in the laboratory to concentrate the amount of total moving sperm and maximize the effectiveness of the procedure. Once the sperm are prepared, it is easily placed through the cervix into the woman's uterine cavity with a tiny catheter. This is the first line of treatment for unexplained infertility, mild endometriosis, or mild male factor problems. This process can be used in a woman who is either using a natural cycle method to determine ovulation or using fertility medication. With a natural cycle, she times ovulation using a simple over-the-counter ovulation predictor kit. When the kit demonstrates impending ovulation, she will call the clinic and the IUI procedure will be done that day or the next day, equally effective either day. If we use fertility medication, and these are just using pills, the woman would take these medications for several days and then come back to the office, usually about a week later, to determine by ultrasound the size of the follicular cysts or follicles. Those follicles have microscopic eggs, and based on the size of the follicles, we will then determine when the woman will receive a trigger injection to mature the follicles in order to release the eggs and time the IUI procedure. The benefit of IUI is that it is much simpler, less costly, and less invasive for the woman compared to IVF. The cost of a cycle is anywhere from $1,000 to $2,000 per month. The woman is using medications by mouth as opposed to injections with in vitro fertilization. And it can be performed simply in the office while the woman is awake and the partner is right next to her. The success rates of using fresh or frozen sperm can be as high as 20% based on the woman's age and diagnosis. What is in vitro fertilization? In vitro fertilization, or IVF, is the most advanced assisted reproductive technology that's available today. And this is where sperm and eggs are combined in the laboratory, as opposed to IUI, where sperm are placed into a woman's uterine cavity to meet the egg inside the woman's body. IVF involves stimulating a woman's ovaries with daily injectable medications for usually 10 days, while she's being monitored with ultrasound and blood work every several days. When the follicles are of a size that is deemed mature, then a trigger injection is given to time the egg retrieval. Now, an egg retrieval is performed in an office-based surgery center, placing a woman under intravenous conscious sedation, and then an ultrasound is placed through the vagina, whereby a needle is guided into the ovary to vacuum out the eggs. Once the eggs are collected in the laboratory, sperm are added later that day for fertilization. The procedure is fairly simple and safe with minimal complications, and the woman is usually discharged within the hour from the surgery center to recover at home and usual return to work the following day. Now, the embryologist will monitor the embryos in the laboratory, and embryo transfer, if it's in a fresh cycle, is typically on day 3 or day 5, based on individual circumstances and clinic recommendations. Extra embryos, or sometimes all the embryos, are frozen for a subsequent frozen embryo replacement cycle. So who might benefit from IVF? The conditions for a woman are typically if the fallopian tubes are blocked, if she is unresponsive to fertility medication or unsuccessful with a lack of ovulation, advanced endometriosis, or if she has severe diminished ovarian reserve from a low number of eggs, or if it's deemed that she has poor egg quality. The last situation would be egg donation or desiring IVF surrogacy. Egg donation is using another woman's eggs, fertilizing with the sperm of her choice, and then transferring the embryo inside her. IVF surrogacy is using her eggs or an egg donor, and then placing the embryos inside a surrogate. Male factor reasons to proceed with in vitro fertilization involve extremely low sperm count or even no sperm in the ejaculate, as well as a history of a vasectomy where sperm would be retrieved from the man's testes and then injected into the woman's eggs through a procedure called ICSI, or intracytoplasmic sperm injection, to achieve fertilization. So this slide illustrates the basic difference between IUI and IVF. On the left, you could see a tiny catheter going through the woman's cervix into the uterus, and the sperm are gently deposited in the top of the uterus. The wash itself enhances fertilization potential, and the placement of the sperm in the upper part of the uterus diminishes the distance that the sperm have to travel to reach the egg. On the right, IVF involves ultrasound-guided needle aspiration into the ovary to vacuum out the eggs. That fluid aspirated from each follicular cyst is then given to the embryologist for examination to determine the eggs for subsequent fertilization. IVF is generally recommended for couples that have failed to conceive after 3 unsuccessful stimulated IUI cycles. According to the Society for Assisted Reproductive Technology, the IVF success rate in the United States for women of all ages is around 30%. However, when women are under the age of 35, the IVF success rates are much greater. So I hope that you have been able to understand the differences between intrauterine insemination and in vitro fertilization. So your next steps would be some research. One is your insurance provider to determine the degree of fertility coverage, if any, then a clinic's success rates before committing to treatment by visiting www.sart.org. It is important to note that comparing clinics is not advisable because patient populations will vary. Then, once you've decided, you can consult a board-certified reproductive endocrinology and infertility specialist. I hope you've enjoyed this educational session, and good luck to you all.